There's no fuel has to flow, no pumps have to start, no nothing. You just, as soon as you, it's instant and it's addictive. You don't even have to go that fast, just the even low speed driving. And there's no sound other than like the sound of the wind or the tires, or there's no electric, little whine from the electric motor in the back. That's it. It's just a different experience. I'll never go back.
That was so sort of my next question is, so how do you compare it to driving a fuel car? Is there any comparison for you?
No. Like, it just, they all feel so sluggish and just noisy and just everything undesirable in a vehicle. Like, even the fast ones, you gotta wait for the transmission to downshift, or you gotta do it yourself if you're in a manual car. And there's like lots of noise involved. I'm not too fan of that. Like, some people, they love the noise of an engine, right? I don't suffer from that particular condition. So it's a good fit for me. It may not be for everybody just yet, but I think eventually that there's not going to be much of an excuse. They're going to achieve cost parity with gas cars, and you're going to be able to buy this dinosaur juice car, or you're going to be able to buy this electric car that you can charge anywhere for very fifth, I think it is, running costs versus a gas car. And it's really no contest when you put them on level playing field, right?
In buying an electric car, from what I'm getting from you is that sort of the main factors were sort of the driving aspects, the car aspects. Was an environmental little consideration?
That's a bonus. Like, it's not really something that was driving the purchase decision, but it's a nice bonus to know that I'm not, like, they say, well, you're not putting out any emissions out the back, but you're getting it from a dirty coal plant or whatever, so it's not really any different, but it is, because you don't have to get it from the coal plant. You can get it from hydro or like any of the cleaner sources, nuclear even. So there is that aspect of it that's positive, but like I said, it didn't really influence my decision at all. I just like the drive and the looks and the benefits.
I think that's all the questions.
Okay. Something I'd like to highlight though is that because the drivetrain is so small, like the equipment to put the transmission and the engine and stuff, it's all only about the size of a golf bag. So they just threw it right between the wheels. And the reason they do that is so they have so much room for everything else to work on in the trunk back here. It's not tight.
You can fit two children in there.
Yeah.
And I have, and in the other car,
two small adults.
Yeah, you flip up the seat, and there's a kid seat that you can put in the back.
Yeah, it's optional. I didn't get it because I didn't have any kids, but it's two rear facing seats, like the old station wagons, and it would fold down into this well here. But since I don't have the option, I could just get to throw on my crap. This is where the drive train is.
It becomes a seven-seater sedan.
I also get a frunk. Because, of course, no engine. So you throw all your groceries or a carry-on bag or whatever in there, in addition to having a large trunk, so the storage.
The only maintenance you have to do right there.
Yeah.
The washer fluid.
Maintenance wise, it's you have to worry about tire wear and the washer fluid.
And where do you charge it?
Where is the charging box?
Right back here.
They try tried to, since this is a first generation car, they tried to keep things as similar to gas cars for people that don't know. It's kind of hidden. Plug that into here and then you're done. It just kind of blends in. So there's another one on the other side that doesn't open, so it's symmetrical. But no, something that they never talk about, like in all the articles about Tesla or electric vehicles, is just how nice they are to drive. And just so smooth, like you're never in the wrong gear, it's just everything that could be pleasant about a drive. Quiet, smooth.
On that topic. Any way we could come out for a ride with you?
Sure.